Hello everyone, this is SMD Mazharul Haq from ISL Engineering College, and today our topic is board plot. So welcome to the board plot topic, and let us begin now. Frequency response plots. So frequency response analysis of control systems can be carried either analytically or graphically. So various graphical techniques are available for frequency response analysis. So these are few of the response analysis techniques: board plot, polar plot, Michaelis plot, Mn circles, and Nichols chart. Out of these, we are having here board plot. So what is a board plot? We will study. A board plot is a frequency response plot of a sinusoidal transfer function of a system. A board plot consists of two graphs. One is a plot of magnitude of a sinusoidal transfer function versus log omega, and the other plot is of a phase angle of a sinusoidal transfer function versus log omega. So board plot has two graphs. The board plot can be drawn for both open loop and closed loop systems. Usually the board plot is drawn for open loop system. The standard representation of logarithmic magnitude of open loop transfer function g of j omega is 20 log g of j omega. So g of j omega is 20 log g of j omega is the logarithmic magnitude of open loop transfer function. Okay, where the base of logarithm is 10. The unit used here is, your unit is decibel, usually abbreviated as dB. The curves are drawn on semi-log paper using the log scale for frequency and linear scale for either magnitude in decibels or phase angle in degrees. Now the main advantage of the board plots is that multiplication of magnitudes can be converted into addition. Also a simple method for sketching an approximate log magnitude curve is available. So if you consider open loop transfer function, g of s is equals to k into 1 plus st1 by s into 1 plus st2 into 1 plus st. So what you have to do here is, in place of s you have to write j omega. K into 1 plus j omega t1 divided by j omega into 1 plus j omega t2 into 1 plus j omega t3. After doing this, we have to write this as k at an angle 0 degrees, square root of 1 plus omega square t1 square at an angle of tan inverse omega t1. So we have finding the magnitude as well as the angle for this. And here also j omega means we can write 90 degrees. Omega at an angle 90 degrees is nothing but j omega. So in the polar form we are writing here. And also we can write here magnitude as square root of 1 plus omega square t2 square, tan inverse of omega t2, and root of 1 plus omega square t3 square tan inverse omega t3. So this is the open loop transfer function where s value is substituted by j omega, and j omega in this rectangular form is converted to a polar form like this. Okay. Next, after finding out this form, now the phase angle of j omega is equals to tan inverse omega t1 and minus 90 minus tan inverse omega t2 minus tan inverse omega t3. The magnitude of j omega can be expressed in decibels as shown below. That is, g of j omega in dB is equals to 20 log g of j omega. That is equals to 20 log k into square root of 1 plus omega square t1 square by omega into square root of 1 plus omega square t2 square into square root of 1 plus omega square t3 square. Okay, after doing this one, what you have to do is next step. That is equal to 20 log k by omega into 1 square root of 1 plus omega square t1 square into 1 by square root of 1 plus omega square t2 square into square root of 1 plus omega square t3 square. This all gives you the equation 3.29. After solving this one, you get this equation 3.29. From the above equation 3.29, it is clear that when magnitude is expressed in dB, the multiplication is converted to addition. Hence, in magnitude plot, the dB of the individual factors g of j omega can be added. Now we will go to the basic factors of g of j omega. The basic factors that are very frequently occurring in a typical transfer function g of j omega are constant gain k, integral part in factor k by j omega or k by j omega power n, and derivative factor k into g j omega or k into j omega whole power n, and first order factor in denominator 1 by 1 plus j omega t or 1 by 1 plus j omega t whole power m, and first order factor in numerator, that is 1 plus j omega t or 1 plus j omega t whole power m. Now quadratic factor of denominator, it can be written like this, and quadratic factor in numerator also can be written in this way, 1 plus 2 zeta into j omega omega n plus j omega by omega n whole square. Now constant gain k is also found out. G of s is equals to k, g of j omega is equals to k is at an angle 0 degrees. So we want to find out a is equals to my modulus or magnitude of g of j omega in dB is called as 20 log k. So we have to find out this 20 log k. These values are remembered when we are doing the board plotting. It is very helpful for us. So phi is equals to at an angle g of j omega is equal to 0 degrees. So now we can represent this one like this. Omega is log scale and dB is y scale here, that is x axis omega and y axis is in dB. So for k greater than it is a line dB here, and k is equal to 1 at dB is equal to 0 and minus dB k is less than 1. So here we are given with this. Okay, next. Now integral factor. Now if a function is given like g of s is equals to k by s, then g of j omega is equals to k by j omega, that is k by omega at an angle minus 90 degrees. Just we are writing it in the polar form. J is nothing but it is minus 90 degrees. So k by omega at an angle minus 90 degrees. Now as we have said already how to find out A in dB, A is the magnitude of g of j omega. So it will become 20 log k by omega, 20 log k by omega. So after finding A value, then phi value is g of j omega. So what is this g of j omega at an angle? Minus 90 is showing. So it is minus 90 degrees is the angle. When omega is equal to 0.1k, then A is equals 20 log 1 by 0.1, that is equals to 20 dB. And when omega is equals to k, then 20 log 1 is equal to 0 dB. Like that, we are having here some scale 0.1k, k and 10k. Depending on that, what we are doing here, we are plotting the graph. So if you are plotting the graph is coming like 20 dB, 0 and minus dB, from 20 to 0 and 0 to minus 20. Like that, after having this same thing, when an integral factor is calculated, g of s is equals to k by s power n, only s power n is there, instead of k by s, it is k by s power n. So it will be the same thing carried out here, 20 log k by omega power n, and therefore the angle will be minus 90 at an n degrees, and also A is equals to 20 n log k whole power 1 by n by omega. Now derivative factor, what is the derivative factor? It tells us about how the Bode plot of a derivative factor is there. So Bode plot of a derivative factor is like it is a slope having the rising from minus 20 to plus 20, because the values are also rising from 0.1k to 1k and 10k, it is minus 20 dB and 0 dB and 20 dB. Like that it is rising slope here for the values of this 0.1 by k and 1 by k and 10 by k here. Okay, for a derivative factor we will be taking in this way, 0.1 by k, 1 by k and 10 by k. For integral factor we will be taking 0.1 k, k and 10k. Okay, so this is what we have been understood by the derivative factor and the integral factor. So integral factor is having the graph in this way, and derivative factor is having the graph in this way depending upon the value. So derivative factor is k s, k into s, and integral factor is k by s. So k by s, the graph will be coming down here, and for the derivative factor the graph will be moving from minus to plus dB. Next is the procedure for magnitude plot of the Bode plot. From the analysis of previous sections, the following conclusions can be obtained. The constant gain k, integral and derivative factors contribute the gain magnitude at all frequencies. Now in approximate plot, the first quadratic and higher order factors contribute gain magnitude only. So now for first of all we will take one example. This is an illustrated example of that. G of s is equals to k into 1 plus st1 whole square by s square into 1 plus st2 into 1 plus st3. Now we have written this equation. After writing this equation, what we do here is g of j omega is equals to k into 1 plus j omega t1 whole square divided by j omega square into 1 plus j omega t2 into 1 plus j omega t3. As I have said you, to substitute the in the place of s, j omega. Now here t2 is less than t3 less than t1. We are assuming it. Now the corner frequencies, corner frequencies are omega c1 is equals to 1 by t1, 1 by t2 and 1 by t3. So what is corner frequency? Corner frequency is nothing but the frequency from where the asymptotes are passing through, or break points are passing through, is called as the corner frequency. If you want to find out a corner frequency from the equation, it is given 1 plus st1 here. So the corner frequency is omega c1 is equals to 1 by t1, omega ct is equals to 1 by t2 and omega c3 is equals to 1 by t3 from this equation. So here let omega c1 is less than omega c3 less than omega c2. The magnitude plot of in the individual terms of g of j omega and their combined magnitude are shown. Now we will go through the step by step procedure for plotting the magnitude plot, and it is written here like this. Convert the transfer function into Bode form or time constant form. The Bode form of the transfer function is g of s is equals to k into 1 plus st1 by s into 1 plus st2 into 1 plus s square by omega n square plus 2 zeta s by omega n. Now substituting s is equal to g omega, we get k into 1 plus g omega t1 by j omega into 1 plus g omega t2 into 1. So it is minus s square by omega n square plus 2 omega n s. We are substituting the values of j omega and we get a value here, right? Now the second step, what is second step? List the corner frequency, the increasing order, and prepare a table as shown below. So what it has? It has a term, it has a corner frequency, it has a slope and change in slope. While doing the problem, we will be writing these values depending upon the equation. Okay, now we will see here that we also have the step 3. What is step 3? Choose an arbitrary frequency omega L which is lesser than the lowest corner frequency. So arbitrary frequency omega L should be lesser than the lowest corner frequency. Now here we have calculated omega C1, omega C2 and omega C3. Arbitrary frequency should be less than this frequency. Calculate the dB magnitude of K or K by j omega n at the lower corner frequency. Okay. So just now we have drawn the graph. So for K by j omega square, how the graph will be? For magnitude plot of the term K by j omega square, as we said that for a denominator, if it is K by j omega, the graph will be downwards. And the magnitude plot for the term 1 plus j omega t1, it is a having numerator, not having any denominator here. If it is K by something j omega, then it is reducing. If it is 1 plus j omega t1, it is increasing like this. So from 0. Okay, next, suppose magnitude plot for the term 1 plus j omega t3. Suppose it is 1 plus j omega t3. How would be the plot? The plot would be like this. Because it is a reciprocal, 1 by, it will be coming downwards. Here also 1 by 1 plus j omega t2, it is also coming downwards here. So all these magnitude plot, Bode plot of this function k into 1 plus j omega t1 by j omega square and 1 plus j omega t2, 1 plus j omega t3 is this. Combination of all these things, that is 40 dB and next is 0 dB and minus 20 dB and minus 40 dB. Like this, you will be having the function k 1 plus j omega t1. 1 plus j omega t1, how you are writing this particular, for this you are writing the equation, that is 20 dB and 40 dB and minus 40 dB. Depending upon this particular function, we are drawing the Bode plot. Okay. Now, what is step 4? Now, calculate the gain dB magnitude at every corner frequency one by one by using the formula. Now, negative slope and positive slope occur when the particular thing is given. And if you are writing here, change in gain is from omega x to omega y plus gain at omega x. So we can write the gain at omega y is equal to change in gain from omega x plus omega y plus gain at omega x. What is step 5? Choose an arbitrary frequency omega h which is greater than the highest corner frequency. Calculate the gain at omega h by using the formula in step 4. So what is formula in step 4? This is step 4 formula, and from this formula you have to find out the step 5 also. Arbitrary frequency omega h as you have done in omega l. Okay. Now after finding this arbitrary frequency, now step 6 is, in a similar graph sheet, mark the required range of frequency on x-axis log scale and the range of dB magnitude on y-axis after choosing the proper unit. So students, you have to draw this graph on a similar graph sheet. Similar graph sheet is not a normal graph sheet. It will be having the dB as well as the wave frequency, dB on y axis and frequency on the x axis. So we will come to know when you are doing the problem in this session. Now mark all the points obtained in step 3, 4, 5 on the graph and join the points by straight lines. Mark the slope at every part of the graph. These things we are starting now. So what is the procedure? Procedure, as we have discussed now, how to draw the procedure of the phase plot of the board plot. The phase plot is extract plot, exact plot, and no approximations are made while drawing the phase plot. As we already seen that what is the this particular magnitude plot, now it is phase plot. I said that board plot has both two graphs, that is, one is the magnitude plot and the phase plot. So we have completed about the magnitude plot, now about the phase plot. So it is what it is called as the exact plot. Now the choice of frequency, or preferably the frequency, is chosen for magnitude plot. So frequencies do not vary here, frequency will remain the same in the phase plot as in the magnitude plot only. So usually the magnitude plot and phase plot are drawn in a single semi-log sheet on a common frequency scale. So this point is very important. On a common frequency scale we are drawing these two graphs. Now take another y-axis. So we see here in the graph where magnitude plot is drawn on the y-axis, mark these are the range of phase angles and join the points of the smooth curve. So this is called as the phase plot. Now determination of gain margin and phase margin from the board plot. So after drawing these two graphs, we are finding out the gain margin and phase margin also. How to find the gain margin and phase margin? The gain margin in dB is given by the negative of the dB magnitude of g of j omega at phase crossover frequency at omega pc. Then omega p naught is the frequency at which j of j omega is minus 180 degrees. If dB magnitude of g of j omega at omega pc is negative, then gain margin also positive. Now let gain crossover frequency be the phase angle of g of j omega. At a gain crossover frequency g of j omega gc, the omega gc is frequency at which dB magnitude of g of j omega is 0. Now the phase margin gamma is given by gamma is equals to 180 degrees plus this particular angle gain crossover frequency. Now we will see the how this gain margin, phase margin are drawn from the board plot. So are you seeing this graph? In this graph, this is the positive phase margin and this is the positive gain margin. After drawing the board plot and the phase plot, we are going to see this phase margin as well as gain margin in the graphs. Now here you are seeing this negative margin here and as well as the negative gain margin here. So according to the graph, we will be observing some gain margin, that is positive or negative, we will be seeing in the board plot. In a similar way, we can do the gain adjustment also. So gain adjustment also we can do, that is suppose you are having the gain adjustment. How to do the gain adjustment? We will be having a point in complex plane, that is represented by rectangular coordinates or the bipolar coordinates here. So we will see that how we are adjusting the gain adjustment in the board plot in the problem. Next, we will come to the problem now. Sketch the board plot for the following transfer function and determine the system gain k for gain crossover frequency to be 5 radians per second. In this particular problem, we will be discussing about the how to draw the board plot, that is magnitude plot and the phase plot. So g of s is equals to ks square by 1 plus 0.2s into 1 plus 0.02s. Now first step, what is our first step? The sinusoidal transfer function g of j omega is obtained by replacing by g omega in the given s domain transfer function. So this is the s domain transfer function, and for the s domain transfer function we are writing here j omega. So writing here j omega in the place of s, what you are doing here is substituting this one and keeping let k is equals to 1. So j omega square by 1 plus j into 0.2 omega into 1 plus j into 0.02 omega. Now magnitude plot. The corner frequencies are omega c1 is equal to 1 by 0.2, because 1 by t1, as you have studied in the previous slide, how to find out the corner frequency, omega c1 is equals to 1 by 0.2. This is 1 by 0.2 of this first term. Next, omega C2 is equals to 1 by 0.02, that is 50 radians per second. Now, various terms of G of J omega are listed in the table 1 in the increasing order of their corner frequencies. Also, the table shows the slope contributed by each term and the change in slope at the corner frequency. We will see how this slope changes. Now, the term is J omega square, right here J omega square. So, we don't have any corner frequency for this like that. So, 0. Slope is 40. Slope is here 40. Now, and here the change in slope is 0. Nothing. The slope hasn't changed here. So, here you are writing J omega square, you are taking as 40, because always you should remember that here if it is J omega, you can take 20 as a slope here. If it is J omega square, you can take 40. If it is J omega cube, you can take here 60 degrees. 60 is as a slope. Now, if it is 1 by J omega, you can take minus 20. 1 by J omega square, you can take minus 40. 1 by minus J omega cube, you can take here minus 60. So, please remember this point. J omega square is equals to 40. Okay, J omega square is a term, it is 40 here. Now, 1 by 1 plus J into 0.2 omega. So, what is the corner frequency? 1 by 0.2, that is 5 radians per second. And here slope, what is the slope here? As I told you that 1 by some J 0.2 omega means it is minus 20 only. Now here 1 by 1 plus J into 0.02, corner frequency is 50, as we have already solved here. Then here the slope is 20. Why? Because it is the frequency that is coming here, minus 20, and this is the plus 20. Now choose a frequency omega such that what you are doing here is next is change in the slope. So how to find the change in slope here? So see here 40 degrees, and from 40 you are having 40 to minus 20, that is 20, and minus 20 to this one change is there, that is 20 minus 20, it is 0. So what is we are doing here is you are making this change in slope. How the slope has changed? 40 to 20, that is 20, and 20, minus 20 to 20, it is 0 here. So what you are doing here is you are finding out the values of the particular transfer function. So here you are writing the slope also, 1 by 1 plus J into 0.02. So you can write here 20. Now choose a low frequency omega 1 so that omega is equal to less than omega's corner frequency, and choose a high frequency omega such that omega is greater than omega C2. Now let omega 1 is equal to 0.5 radians per second and omega H is equal to 100 radians per second. Now if you calculate at omega 1 is equal to omega C1 and omega C2 and omega N, we are getting at omega is equal to omega 1 L arbitrary value, A is equal to 20 log J omega square. For this first term, it is minus 12 dB. At omega is equal to omega C1, it is 28 dB. At omega is equal to omega C2, it is 48 dB. At omega is equal to omega H, it is 48 dB. So these are the number of this arbitrary functions, arbitrary constant also you can say for A value. Now let the points A, B, C be on the points corresponding to frequencies omega L, omega C1, omega C2 and omega H. Now magnitude plot in the semi-log sheet to a scale of 1 unit is equal to 10 dB on Y axis, and the frequencies are marked in decades from 0.1 to 100. Now phase plot. What is phase plot here? Phase plot is equal to angle of G of J omega is equal to 180 minus tan inverse 0.2 minus tan inverse 0.02 omega. So you have to make a table like this, omega value, and later you have to take this tan inverse 0.2 omega, tan inverse 0.02 omega, and phi value, and point on the phase plot where you are drawing the phase plot. So like that you are calculating the value of k also, 20 log k, g of j omega is equal to 20 log k, and we are getting that minus 28 dB. We are getting it as minus 28 dB. So the k value is 0.0398. So here we got minus 28 dB, as here we are seeing the previous value here, we are calculated here, that is 28 dB. But omega C1 that is 20 log K is equal to 28 dB from this value. Okay. Now after getting this value, then actually the board, the exact plot should be omega is equal to 5 radians per second, should be 3 dB less than the actual plot. So what you have to do here, you have to reduce the 3 dB here, and 20 log k is equals to minus 25 dB and k is equal to 0.562. Okay. Now we will see this board plot. Actually, what we have discussed till now, we are writing it here in the board plot. It is, we are having minus 20, minus 12, minus 10, 0, 10, 20, 28, 30, 40, 40, 50, like that on the y axis. And here 0.1, 0.5, 1, 5, 10, 50, 100 omega in radians per second. So whatever you have calculated here for different values of k, we are mentioning this particular magnitude plot. So for the magnitude plot is for with k is equals to 1, we are taking here. With k is equals to 1, we are taking the magnitude plot. That is, first we are having here 40. See here the magnitude plot, it is having 40, and here next slope minus 20 and 20 here. So the similar way, you can see that here you are having 40 and 20. Okay, and here it is a 0 dB. So if you see here the 0.5, it is starting at 0.5 here, and it is minus 12 dB. So let us go back and see here minus 12 dB is the value, omega is equal to omega 1, minus 12 dB, and 28 and also 48 dB, we are going to get the this particular A values here. We are plotting here A values, minus 12, 28 and this 48, 48 here. This dotted line shows the A values. After having these A values, where this A value will be coinciding with this particular plot here, we will be drawing now. Now we will see that 0.5, what is this 0.5, and this is a particular value 5, and this is a particular value here 10, 10 is also there here. Okay, these different values are there for this magnitude plot, and we can draw depending upon our knowledge of this particular function. And phase plot, from the phase plot, E, F, G, H, I, J are the points, and this angle is 174, 168, 130, 106, 50 and 30. So depending on that, we are drawing the phase plot. These points are given and the phase plot is drawn depending upon the points like this. So in frequency versus phi, and here it is dB versus this particular frequency. So frequency versus dB, and here you are drawing the graph for this particular phi and frequency. So this is magnitude plot and this is the phase plot. Okay. Now if you see the other problem for a board plot. So board plot, the first step is you are writing the values in terms of this j omega. So on comparing what we get the values here, you are writing, and for standard quadratic equation, that is the square plus 2 theta omega n plus omega n square is there. On comparing, we get omega n value, and omega n is nothing but 2 theta omega n. Omega n square is equal to 100, so omega n is equal to 10. And 2 zeta omega n is equals to 16, so zeta is equals to 0.8. Now converting this given function into your j omega value, so 0.75 into 1 plus 0.2 j omega divided by j omega into 1 plus 0.01 into j omega square plus 0.16 into j omega. So what I am doing here is, I am taking 75 into 1 plus 0.2 s by s into s square. Again, I am taking out the 100 common here. Why? Because I want 1 here. So, I am taking 100 common and keep it in like this. So, after writing this j omega and substituting, we get these values. Now, magnitude plots. The corner frequencies are omega c1 is equals to 1 by 0.2 and that is equals to 5 radians per second. And omega c2 is equals to omega 10 radians per second. The first term 0.75 by j omega, and the slope is minus 20 dB by j omega, and here is 1 plus 0.2 j omega, and the slope is here 20, and here 1 by 1 minus 0.01 omega square plus j into 0.16 omega, it is minus 40 omega square term, and here got the minus 40 value. Now change in slope, minus 20 to 20 it is 0, and 22 minus 40 it is, and after from to minus, minus 20 to 20 it is 0, and from 0 to this particular minus 40 it is minus 40. So choose a low frequency omega and one omega L and omega H high frequency such that they are greater than the this particular frequency. Okay. Now we will calculate this A value at omega 1, omega C 1, omega C 2. That is, we got 3.5 dB and 16 dB, and this particular omega C 2 you are finding out minus 16.5 dB. After this, all these things, what you do here is you are having the this particular value to be remembered and draw the graph and phase plot. In the phase angle of G of J omega, as a function of omega is given, phi is equals to this formula should be written tan inverse 0.2 omega minus 90 minus tan inverse 0.016 omega by 1 minus 0.01 omega square for omega less than or equal to omega n. So this formula, after writing this formula, we have to find out the phi values. For greater than n, for omega greater than omega n, we have to write this formula. Now after taking the table 2 of this problem, first you have to write the frequency. Next, tan inverse 0.2 omega, tan inverse this value 1 minus 0.01 omega square, and later phi. Next, points E, F, G, H, I, J, K, that are points of the phase plots. For each value, we are drawing the point. Now, if you see here, we can see the points E, F, G, H, I here. E, F, G, H, I are here towards the frequencies. Frequencies and this particular things are drawn, and you are drawing a phase plot for this. So if you see here any of the frequencies, if I tell you that this frequency is 0.5 frequency at the value E, 0.5 at the value E. So E is here, it is 0.5 and E is minus 89. Okay, this is your phase plot. You are plotting the phase like this. So what you do next is you are finding out the this particular other value phase and drawing these things, and this is called as your phase margin. Phase margin is phi is equal to 92 degrees. So you have to see that how much gap is left out here, and we can calculate it is minus 92 degrees. So if you ask to find out the particular phase margin, you can find out this phase margin here. And if you ask you to find out the gain margin, also you can find out. As I said you that there should be that particular part should be there where you are having the point, last point here, and from there you are having the last this degree, phi in degree, is called as the phase margin. And if you want to find out this particular formula, phase margin is equals to 180 plus phi of G gain crossover frequency, 180 minus 88 degrees. 88 degrees already we have calculated, or we can write here this is phi is equal to 88 is the gain crossover frequency. So this at this point you are having the, this is a gain crossover frequency where you are having this 0 dB per second, where it has become 0 dB per second is called as the gain crossover frequency. Now if you see the plot here, 3.5 for the value of 3.5, and for all these values we are drawing the graph here, and minus 16.5 we have calculated the A values, 3.5 minus 16.5 and minus 28.5 dB. We are plotting it then towards this y axis as well as frequency we are plotting here, and this slope is taken from the table. This table is there, and from this we are taking the table minus 20, 20 and minus 40. And if you see here, minus 20 and next is 0 and next is minus 40 dB as from the problem, from the table. Minus 20 and it is 0 and again minus 40. So the change in slope is drawn, minus 20, 0 and minus 40 here. So depending upon the change in slope, what we are writing here is you will be mentioning that particular values there. Okay, so minus 20 dB per second was there instantly at this particular 3.5. We are drawing the graph minus 20 dB per decibel, and here this -16.5 it was 0, as you have seen in the table now, and again we have seen -40 at -28.5 it was point. So A, B, C, D were the points there, and we have find out this particular plot. In this way, we are having one more equation or one more problem like this. The similar way we can plot the graphs. So the first step is omega c1 is equals to 2.5 radians per second. Omega c2 we have to find out depending on the particular values. Given by j omega, and here you are saying, as I said, that 1 by j omega is there, minus 20 is the slope, and here 1 by 1 plus j 0.5 omega is there. You can write here minus 20 slope, and here also 1 by 0.1 omega minus 20 slope. Now the change in slope, minus 20 to minus 20, it is minus 40. So you can write minus 40. Minus 40 to minus 20, it is minus 60. So like that we are writing this table, and this table is very helpful for us. And we can see that at omega is equals to omega n, A is equal to 20 log 10 by j omega, that is 40 dB. And these values of A are coming on the y-axis. For different omega c1, omega c2 corner frequencies and omega n, we are calculating it. Okay. So for this particular thing, we see that we are calculating the values of A, and this is the phase margin. Okay. Now we see that this problems can be done in the same way, where 20 log k is equals to 30, k is equals to 10 power 30 by 20, and k is equals to 31.62. Like this, we can solve the problem also. Okay. So number of problems we can solve on the board plot. Having this particular equations, you can write and solve the problems and get the phase margin and also gain margin, also the phase plot and the gain plot. So we can find out the magnitude plot as well as the this particular phase plot. This is called as the this board plot. Together, magnitude plot and the phase plot is called as the board plot. So here we have completed our two problems on this board plot. How we have done is, first of all, we have as the procedure was there, we have followed all the seven steps to find out the board plot here. So this board plot is mentioned here as is the semi-log sheet. The semi-log sheets has this particular A in dB, and this is the radians per second omega. So mainly we have to write these values depending upon the tables given in the this particular problem. Okay. So I would like to end the class here, students. Thank you.